Guys, this is Amardeep Srivastav, and in the previous lecture I have completed the concept of piezoelectric material, ferroelectric material and different type of concept related to them. Now in this lecture, this is lecture number 18 for material science engineering and for engineering services examination, I am going to start a new topic, that is I am going to dive in magnetic materials. This is very much important. If you are preparing for engineering services examination, this topic is very much important. For GS section or for technical section also, and you can also expect question related to this in mains exam also. So you need to be very much careful about magnetic materials in material science engineering. Now before starting magnetic material, I just like to introduce which source I am using for magnetic material. I am using SP Seth. This is a very good book for magnetic plus electrical material. You can refer it, but I will suggest you to refer it for only for a few references. Don't go in deep dive because you need not to go that much. Now for starting magnetic material, I would like to say that I have taken a conducting rod. Now in this conducting rod, let's assume a current I is flowing. Now, as we know that when a conductor is carrying a current, it induces a magnetic field linked with that conductor, and the direction of that magnetic field and the orientation of that magnetic field is given by the, we can decide by the right hand thumb rule. So I can't explain you through this conducting wire, but I will say you just put your thumb in the direction of current flowing and wrap your fingers like this. And on wrapping, you will tend to know that the current is flowing in this direction, hence wrapping of is in this direction. So you can say that the direction of magnetic field which is introduced is like this, and its direction will be like this. So now here I would like to say how to give cross and dot, that is where the magnetic field lines are entering and where the magnetic field lines are emerging. So you need to be very much careful for crossing the point. If this magnetic field of lines is entering in this space, let's say it is entering here, let's assume it as an arrow, it's entering in here, so you can say that it's cross. It's just a convention, you need not to think, but it's just a convention. So cross, that is entering in this point, and leaving that point is dot. So now here, if you will wrap the fingers in the direction of current flow, or thumb in the direction of current flow, and wrapping the fingers, you will get the direction like this. Here you will get that the current is going inside, that is here will be cross, that is the magnetic field polarity will be cross, and this side the current will be is entering, you can say that it will be dot. Now if I will take let's complete the circuit. I mean to say that let's take a ring. I'm taking a ring, okay, and I have flown the current I, let's say like this and this in this ring. Now what will be the direction, or what will be the direction of that magnetic field? So you can say that here, if I'm talking about this portion. So you can say, if I will put my thumb here and I will wrap my finger like this, so you can say that there will be magnetic field induced, it will be like this, and its direction will be like this. Here also it's entering, you can say it's cross, and here a dot. So likewise, you can give the direction of those magnetic fields, that is those orientation of that magnetic fields, in like cross and dot. Now magnetic flux is related as phi m. Magnetic flux, that is we give, you can say that magnetic flux is same analogous to electric current. I will give you all the analogy, you need not to think about it right now. So I will give you all the analogy related to flux and electric and magnetic circuit. Now talking about magnetic flux density, magnetic flux density. Magnetic flux density is represented by B, vector B, or you can say that it is also known as magnetic induction. Magnetic flux density is defined as magnetic flux per unit area, that is phi m per unit area. Unit of phi m is Weber per meter square, or you can say that Tesla. Tesla is a scientist name. A is what? A is cross sectional area of conductor. Now, so from here you can write it as vector B equals to flux per unit area. Okay, now from here you can induce that phi m equals to vector B, that is magnetic flux density into area of cross sectional of that material. Now this is the equation we can use in case when the flux is uniform. Here flux is uniform. Now let's take when flux is non-uniform. Flux is non-uniform. In this case, flux will be equals to integral over the range of area vector V dot ds, where S is the surface area. So this is the equation, or this is the relation when the flux is not uniform, that is the non-uniform fluxes, that is flux changes as the cross-sectional area of any crystal or any conductor changes. Hence it is variable as per the cross-sectional area related to that, because B related to area, flux per unit area. Hence now I would like to explain you how anything in electrical domain related to anything in mechanical domain. Now in electrical domain, there are some analogy between electrical domain and magnetic domain. So I'm going to introduce you all about these terms. Like electrical domain also requires closed path. For what? For flow of electric current I. Magnetic domain also requires closed path for magnetic flux. Here the flowing, the parameter which will flow is magnetic flux. Flux phi. Now here the current is given as I equals to EMF by resistance. Resistance is a term which opposes resistance. Resistor will oppose, is a device which will carry the property of opposing the value of current, or which will oppose the flow of current. So you can say that in the same manner, on comparing with magnetic domain, you will get phi, that is analogous to current, equals to EMF will be replaced by MMF, magnetomotive force which drives the flux to flow, divided by, here resistance will be replaced by reluctance. Likewise, resistance opposes the flow of current. In the similar manner, reluctance will oppose the flow in fluxes. That is MMF, I will replace reluctance by like this. Now EMF is given by, in electrical domain, E equals to integral I dot dl. We all know that. And in case of magnetic domain, MMF, that is magnetomotive force, the driving force, is given by integral H dot dl. Let me show you what is H. H is magnetic field intensity. I will explain you what is magnetic field intensity, but for now onward, but for right now it's not needed. Now here the flow of current will be opposed by resistor equals to R equals to rho into L by A. In case of magnetic domain, it will be opposed, the flux, moving flux will be opposed by reluctance in magnetic domain, which is given by 1 by mu naught mu R into cross sectional area A. Its unit is ampere turn per Weber. Its unit is ohm. Now in case of electrical domain, the opposite of resistance is what? Is conductance. In case of magnetic domain, the opposite of reluctance is what? Is permanence. In case of electrical domain, if it is conductivity, then it will be permeability, expressed by mu. Now in case of magnetic electrical domain, the term is current density. Current density, the same thing, will be replaced by magnetic flux density, that is B, vector B, in case of magnetic domain. So for current density, you can write it as J equals to current per unit area and its unit is ampere per meter square. And for B, as we all know, flux per unit area, its unit is Weber per meter square or Tesla. Clear? Now, there is a term magnetic intensity or electrical intensity. Magnetic intensity is represented by H and electrical intensity is represented by electric field E or electric field strength, you can say that. It is potential per unit length. It is given by potential per unit length, and in case of magnetic circuit, it is given by magnetic field intensity H equals to Ni by length L. There is an EMF drop in case of electrical circuit that is known as I into R, or you can so say that EMF drop. In case of magnetic domain, it is MMF drop, and it is equals to phi into reluctance. Same I into R, I will be replaced by phi in magnetic domain, R will be replaced by reluctance in magnetic domain, and in simple, it's like that. Now, in case of electrical circuits, electrical dipole exists. In case of electrical dipole, monopole exists. But in case of magnetic dipole, monopoles does not exist. I will explain you what is monopoles. Poles. Now, let's say it's plus Q, minus Q, separated by a distance D. This is the arrangement of dipole, and the total entire arrangement is known as dipole moment. The electric charge flux is originated from positive charge and terminated at negative charge, like this. In case of electric arrangement, positive charge will emit fluxes and it will terminate at negative charge. But in case of a magnet, the fluxes will arise from north and it will terminate at south outside the magnet, and inside it will be flow from south to north. Always remember, in case of electrical machine, that is if you will go to any electrical machine concept, or like why is the current flow or the flux flows in the core, you will have to be very much careful about this term, that outside the magnet the magnetic flux will flows from north to south, that is like this, and inside the magnet it is from south to north. You will have to take care of these things, the analysis will be very simple for electrical machine concepts. Now, magnetic flux, you have to remember also that one point, that magnetic flux lines are always continuous. It is continuous in nature. Now, electrical dipole moment, I have already read, but for analogy concept, I will have to introduce this electric dipole moment. Electric dipole moment is given by PE is equals to Q into D. What is Q? Q will be source of dipole. In case of magnetic dipole moment, it will be represented by PB is equals to source. What induces magnetic flux lines is the current, that is source, into area of that cross-sectional wire in the direction normal to the current flow, normal to the seat, due to the direction of current carrying the dipoles, you can say that. Now, magnetic dipole moments form due to the current, hence its source is the current. You have to remember very much careful about these things. Formed because of current in the loop, that's why I am taking for magnetic dipole moment current as a source. Now, in case of a loop, you can say that if the current flows in anti-clockwise direction, the direction of the pole formation will be north pole, and if the current will flow in the direction in clockwise direction, then it will form south pole. Remember these small points where you, this is the unit vector, because you can never know what UPSC can ask you. at any instant of time. Now, electron. Let me introduce you term related to atomic phenomena. Now, electron, which is negatively charged, revolves around the nucleus. Nucleus ke around revolve karti hai electron. And that revolution will cause magnetic dipole moment. Magnetic dipole moment. And hence this dipole moment is caused because of the orbital motion of that electron. It is known as orbital moments. We have to read the concept related to orbital moments because it is important for prelims points of view. Orbital moment. Let's assume this is nucleus positively charged and these are the cells, and that is house of electrons. Let's assume there is an electron E revolving like this, and at any instant of time, let's take at any instant of time, the radius or the distance between the nucleus to that of electron is R. Okay, now let's assume time taken by the electron to complete one revolution or one rotation is T. Let's say T is the time taken by the electron to rotate one complete rotation. So you can see that angular velocity omega will be equals to what? 2 pi by T. Its unit is radian per second. Why? Because for a complete rotation of 2 pi, the electron is taking, for a complete rotation of 2 pi, the electron is taking T time. It is known as radian per second, that is angular velocity. Now let's assume when the electron revolves around, it produces a current I, which is equals to given by E, that is a charge per unit time taken, that is time period for a complete rotation T. So there is a production of current, hence there will be a production of magnetic moment. So you can say that PV will be given by I into A. I is the source of production of magnetic moment. So you can say that E by T into area will be equals to I, pi R square. Okay, R is the radius of that moving electron on a circular track, let's say. So you can say that T will be equals to what? You can write T as 2 pi by omega. You can write it as like this. We all know that time period of rotation. So using this in this, E by 2 pi by omega into pi R square. Now, so this pi to this pi cancel. You can write it as PB, that is magnetic dipole moment equals to E by 2 omega into R square. We can write it like this. This relation you have to be very much careful because you can expect question related to these terms, so you need to be very much careful. Now, now talking about angular momentum, as per the Bohr's atomic model, as we all know that MBR will be equals to integral multiple of NH by 2 pi, that is N into H by 2 pi. As we all know that this concept in Bohr's, as we have already read in Bohr's atomic model. Now, velocity is given by omega into R. You can write it like this. Now, using this relation in this, what you will get? Using this relation in this, M into omega into R equals to NH by 2 pi. You can write like this. Okay. Now, M into omega into R, MBR, sorry, I have left R. M into omega into R square equals to NH by 2 pi. You can write like this. So replacing omega, that is to getting angular velocity omega, what it will be? Nh by 2 pi m into r square. This is the angular velocity we have get. Now, using this angular velocity concept in magnetic moment concept, that is using in PB equals to E by 2 omega r square, what will be the derived form? Will be using omega equals to nh by 2 pi m r square, PB equals to what? E by 2 into omega will be nh by 2 pi m r square into r square. R square, r square will be cancelled. So you can say that what we will be left with is PB equals to n into eh by 4 pi m. This term is known as Bohr's magnetron. Bohr's magnetron. So you have to remember this anyhow. Bohr's eh by 4 pi m is known as Bohr's magnetron. Now, as we know that as PB equals to what? N into eh by 4 pi m, we know the value of eh 4 pi m, that is electronic charges, h Planck's constant 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 24, m is the mass of an electron. On using these all values in case of magnetic moment concept, you will get PB equals to 9.27 into 10 to the power minus 24 ampere meter square. Its unit is ampere meter square. Its unit is ampere meter square. Now, so you can say that into n. Sorry, I have left with n. Into n. So this is the Bohr's magnetron. Now, if we will talk about, so you can say that one Bohr's magnetron will be equals to what? Using n equals to 1, you will get one Bohr's magnetron will be equals to what? 9.27 into 10 to the power minus 24 ampere meter square. For two Bohr magnetron, n equals to 2, that is 2 into 9.27 into 10 to the power minus 24, you can say. Now, angular motion of a charge, that is koi ek charge hai man lo, this is the electron. If it is angularly, if we will take the angular motion of that charge, you can say it is the complete source of magnetic field. And let me say you that vacuum is the only non-magnetic medium. So I can say that magnetic material gets magnetized on the application of magnetic field. All materials show some magnetic effect, but in many substances the effect are so weak that the materials are often considered to be non-magnetic. However, vacuum is the only non-magnetic medium. Remember this term, vacuum is the only non-magnetic material. So you need to remember this, because you can expect question related to this. Now, as we know that, I will explain BH curve. So lagging of B behind H is permeability mu. I will explain the entire BH curve in my upcoming lectures. You need not to worry about that, because BH curve is very much important. You can expect so many questions related to these terms, BH curve, coercivity, remanence and remaining materials for residual magnetism and all. So you can write it as B equals to, that is magnetic flux density equals to mu into H, where H is magnetic field intensity. Now, this also you have to remember. Now, what is mu? Equals to mu naught into mu r. Mu naught is magnetic permeability of free space or vacuum. Its value is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7 Henry per meter. Mu r is relative permeability of material. Mu r is relative permeability of material. Mu naught into mu r is relative permeability of material. Now, magnetic properties of materials are mainly affected by electron spin. Electron spin. Magnetic properties of material is mainly affected by electron spin. So there is an introduction of a new term known as spin moment. or electron spin dipole moment. So in the next lecture I will complete electron spin and spin moment or electron spin dipole moment, and I will explain different type of magnetic materials like paramagnetic, ferromagnetic, diamagnetic and all. So the next lecture is very much important. If you want the lecture of these notes, if you want the notes of these lecture, you can go to my channel Facebook group. You can say that Gate ESS Simplified, ESS Simplified. Kindly join this group so that we will have a fair discussion on related to question related to material science engineering or any question related to any subject in case of electrical and electronics. So you can join me from Facebook group. Now thank you so much. I am wrapping up right now. Thank you for listening.